How to make better decisions using a decision matrix. If you are doing a project where you have to make complicated decisions with a lot of variables, you might be helped by this trick that I just found out. I'm working on making a third marble machine. The first two machines failed, facepalm moments. And I want to learn how to make better decisions. There's something called a decision matrix. Here's an example. For this machine, I wanted to see how many notes I'm going to use on the vibraphone. And it has a lot of variables. So you can see here, should we have this many notes or should we have a fewer notes? So in order to make this decision, I tried making my own decision matrix. And very high level, how it works is that you put your criteria here. And then you put a weight of the criteria, how important they are. Then you have the design options to the left, right there. And then you give each design options like a score. Then you multiply the score with the weight of the criteria for a total point. So in our case, I found out that the full size off-the-shelf vibraphone design option had most score. But I don't like the single drop option, so I took the second best one, full size off the shelf vibraphone with a double drop, and that looks like this. So this is a super cool, very easy way to kind of get a better map of all your variables in one decision. And I think this is a better option than what I had on my first machine, a handmade 11 note thing made from cardboard. So I think it's better. I found this website, and I'm gonna leave a link in the description, because this link is a perfect tutorial for you to try out making a decision matrix for your own project for yourself. Good luck, I love that tool. So, Martin versus Machine, week 3 summary. I've been live streaming with my friend Sir3K, and it's been kind of a fantastic week. Right?
Oh yeah, it's been wonderful.
Absolutely. So, and it's been quite progress this week, because this is how the CAD looked the first week. And here's the progression the second week. You can see a little more refined. And this is week 3.
Incredible progression right there. Now it's starting to look like a playable machine, right?
We're back to the drawing board because of this vibraphone decision that I'm battling with. So I need to decide how this machine is going to actually be played. And this doesn't look like the previous machines, but if we really go form from function, this is kind of where I am right now. And I don't know if even I would like to build a machine like this. So we're just like examining every option right now. And we can kind of see that we also have this idea with circular vibraphones. So at the moment, everything is really on the table. Now I'm down to the very basic, like, what is this machine? What does it need to do? What are the crucial design requirements? So I'm starting at a much better place than what I did with the first machine. This process that we're in right now is the exact process that I didn't do for Marble Machine X. Because if we look here on the first machine, I think it's obvious that the first two machines were too similar and they failed for that reason. So it's an interesting but daunting process right now, questioning absolutely everything. On the positive side, Marble Machine 3 can play longer music. In last week's summary, we talked about program switching between program A and program B. And our idea was to switch these programming things back and forth like this. And since last week, we have a better solution. Let me show it right here. So for each registrator, we double the registrator, a red and a green one. And they are both activating the same channel, the yellow thing right here. And when gravity takes over, they will fall to the bottom. And then we have a camshaft. This was a suggestion from viewers that can rotate and take care of the individual muting. You can see how the camshaft is hitting the green and the red registrators separately. So let's look at this from the side. We start out in the muted position. You can see nothing is interacting with the yellow link. And then if we rotate the camshaft, it only pushes the red bar up. And if we rotate it back, it's muted again. Then we can rotate it the other direction and we have the green thing linking. And then it's muted again. Then we even have a broader one, the gray one, that engages both of them, as you can see here. And the brilliance with this method is that it's taking the thing that worked perfectly on the Marble Machine X and just using the exact same function, so we don't have any half hits or anything. This will just work, but we can have twice as long music. To make this camshaft rotate, we're using Bowden cables from a lever. And this is an industrial solution. For example, a vroom 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 thing on a motorcycle. I don't know, it's called throttle.
A vroom vroom?
Vroom vroom. It looks like this. You can see there's two cables coming in and opening and closing this rotating valve. And if we need more degrees of rotation, we can just take the Bowden cables around the camshaft like this. And this is an industrial solution. Someone already solved this problem, which is why I think this solution is awesome. We can put these levers anywhere on the machine. And by the way, I have 5 individual levers for each instrument individually, but the gray lever there is a master lever. So that's for all the song, all the instruments at the same time, switching between A and B. And why is this important? As I showed last week, this gives us the ability to tell longer stories. So I'm gonna just show you again, like first half of the programming wheel is in minor like this. I'm gonna play a little fast. Here is half the wheel. So we continue. And normally the wheel would loop here. And we play the same again, but not anymore. A new world appears. We switch to the green lever. And we make a trick. Green second half. So this cool CAD design gives us the ability to play longer music and tell more interesting stories. Here's some viewer suggestions with iterations. And here is our t-shirt designs. I'm using the Wilson and the Mountain. I feel I can conquer any problem. And Sir3K, you're sporting the angle grinder.
Yeah, if any problem occurs, I can just angle grind it away. Because as we know, pain is temporary, glory is forever.
Yeah, and talking about pain, I'm back at the sketchboard, and this is kind of the big theme for this week's summary. I am questioning everything, which I think is very proper to do. I have no clue how I want this machine to look. And in a way, like as I showed before, I think maybe I had too clear vision when I started Marble Machine X. I just wanted to make the first machine again, but better. If you join us on the live streams this week, we're gonna be going through a lot of high level, like these design decisions. Can we make a machine that looks like what you're seeing now? Is it even fun to have like a mechanical orchestra? Or is the whole cool thing like one standing machine? Blah, 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 blah.
Let's not make the same machine again. Make a machine that works, right?
Yeah, we want a machine that works. It's the form from function absolutism design process that we're trying right now. And if we find out in CAD that I don't believe in this machine, I will decide to give up on the project. That's also another possible outcome. So tune in to Wintergatan Live with me and Sir3K to find out. Have a wonderful week, everyone.
Take care.
Take care. See you next week.